The topic is sampling distribution for proportion. So let's read the definition. The definition says the sampling distribution of p hat is normal with mean mu of p hat is equal p, which is the original, which is the proportion of the population, and with standard deviation p times 1 minus p over n, everything square root. But we have conditions that need to be met. One, SRS, which is the simple random sample. And then we need n times p to be bigger or equal than 10, n times 1 minus p bigger or equal than 10. And we want a little n to be less or equal than 10% of big n, means the sample size is supposed to be less or equal than the size of the population, big N. Alright, so let's do this example. Assume that 30% of students at a university wear contact lenses. We randomly pick 100 students. So first, we know that a letter P, which is the proportion of the population, is equal to 30%, which is 0.30 or 0.3. We randomly pick 100 students. So a little n, the size of our sample, which is a little n, is equal to 100. Now we know also that p hat represents the proportion of students in this sample who wear contacts. What's the appropriate model for the distribution of p hat? According to the central limit theorem, as long as those conditions are met, 1, 2, 3, 4, we know that the distribution of p hat is normal. So that one we know for sure. So we have to verify. So let's verify each one of them, all those four conditions. So for one, SRS, which is the simple random sample. Of course, the 100 students were picked up randomly. They were picked randomly. So this is checked because we randomly pick 100 students. Picked 100 students. Alright, for 2, n times p is equal what? N is 100 times p is 0.3. That gave us 30, which is bigger or equal than 10, so that's okay. Number 3, n times 1 minus p. N is 100, 1 minus p, 1 minus 0.3 is 0.7. That gives us 70, bigger or equal than 10, that's checked in. Number 4, we want to make sure that n is less or equal than 10% of big N. N, little n, is what? 100. So can we say that 100 is less or equal than 10% of all? Big N is all the students at that university. Of course, 100 is less or equal than 10% of all students at the university, or at the university. What else we need? Yeah, we need to find the mean. But remember, the mean, the central limit theorem says the mean is just going to be p, which is in our case 0.3. And the standard deviation, so I'm using this definition. Now standard deviation is right there. So standard deviation is equal p, which is 0.30, I'm looking at the definition right here, the formula, times 1 minus p, 1 minus 0.30, which is 0.70, divided by n, the size of the sample, which is 100, then we need to take square root of all that. So use your calculator, it's supposed to get 0.046. Now, move on to question B. What is the probability that more than one-third of this sample were contacts? In other words, we're looking for the probability one-third of the sample, in other words, p hat, will be equal, bigger than one-third, right? So here, just use your calculator. We're going to use normal CDF. So we're going from, let me just do, so this is the proportion of p hat. This is 1 over 3, so we're looking for this area. So we remember the calculator, you need to give it the lower bound, which is 1 over 3. The upper bound, I mean, pick something that's so far, I mean, at least it's going to be four standard deviation from 0.30. So just to be safe, pick 1,000, I know it's really far. Pick any large number. And then you want the mean, which is p, 0.30. And then you want the standard deviation, which is 0.046. Now, all you need to do is use your calculator, and you're supposed to get 0.234. And that's it for this example.